Now we will start exercise 4.2. This is very important exercise. In question first is using the property of the determinant. Together all we have 6 properties, and using these properties and without expanding, remember this, without expanding in exercise 1 to 5, prove that. This we have to prove. So we'll consider left hand side here, that is determinant. X, Y, Z, A, B, C, X plus A, Y plus B and Z plus C. See, remember property 5. What is property 5? If you see any column as a sum of 2 terms, you can split the determinant in 2 determinants. So what we can write here using property 5? X, Y, Z, column 1, column 2 will remain same, and in first determinant we'll write first term of the third column, then plus. Here C1, C2 will remain same, and the third column will be second term of the column. Okay, so this we got after using property 5. Now observe this determinant. This column, these 2 columns are same. So one more property we have. If in a determinant any 2 row or column are identical, that determinant value we can write directly as 0. Isn't it? So this determinant value is 0. What reason we can write? By property. Since 2 columns are identical here. Similarly here also, ABC, these 2 columns are identical, so this determinant value also will be 0. So 0 plus 0 is what? 0, which is right hand side. Next question, here also we should prove this determinant is equal to 0. So we'll consider this determinant delta. Now we will use property 6. So what is property 6? If we do any row or column operation, this determinant value will remain unchanged here. See, we want to get 0. So what we can have in this determinant? Either we can make 2 rows or 2 columns identical, or if by doing any operation, if we'll make any row or column, all element of any row column, any row or column will be 0, then this determinant directly will be 0. Okay, so what 2 things we can do here? We can make element 0, row element or column element 0, or 2 row or column identical we can make. Okay, by doing some operations. Now observe the elements here. If you add A minus B plus B minus C plus C minus A, if you add all these 3 elements, you will get 0. Here also. So what we can do here, R1 we are changing and we are adding R1, R2 and R3. Okay. So which option we are using here? Making one row 0. So what we will get here? See, first row will be, directly I am writing A minus B. See, A minus B plus B minus C plus C minus A. So B minus B, C minus C, A minus A means 0 only. Here also B minus C plus C cancel, plus B minus B cancel, minus A plus A 0. Here also we will get 0. And R2, R3 will remain same. But what will happen to this determinant value? Since we got one complete row is as 0, so answer for this determinant will be 0. So we have proved that delta is 0. This determinant is 0. Question number 3 also, we should prove this determinant 0. So we'll consider let delta. Now see, in one column, the numbers are very big, 65, 75, 86, here 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9. So we'll go for the second option. We'll try to make any two column or any two row identical so that we can get directly 0, because we want to prove that determinant value is 0 here. So what we can do here, see, 65 minus 2 will give 63. 63 is what? 9 into 7. 75 minus 3 is 72. 72 is what? 9 into 8. 86 minus 5 is 81, and 81 is 9 into 9. So we can take 9 common, 7, 8, 9 is the second column entry, isn't it? So what we can do here, we can do C3 we are changing. So we can do C3 minus C1 here. So what we will get here, C1 and C2 will remain same. 65 minus 2 means 63, 72 and 81. Okay, after this what we will do, we will write as 9 into 7, 9 into 8, 9 into 9. Then this 9 we can take common. This is also one of the property. So you will be left with 7, 8 and 9. So in this you have proved that two columns are equal. So that determinant value will be definitely 0. So 9 into 0 is 0, which is right hand side.